the story of the Negro Leagues is so much bigger than the game of baseball. This is a story about the importance of economic empowerment. This is a story about an unprecedented level of leadership that emerged as a result of the formation of these leagues. And then ultimately, this is a story about the social advancement of our country, as Jackie Robinson is handpicked from the great Kansas City Monarchs to break baseball's six-decade-long self-imposed color barrier. And there's no question that Robinson's breaking of the color barrier wasn't just a part of the civil rights movement, it was the beginning of the civil rights movement in this country. This museum is a social justice museum. It is a civil rights museum. It's just seen through the lens of baseball. But just as importantly, it is triumph over that adversity. These incredible athletes dared to dream of playing baseball. They had no idea that they were making history. They didn't care about making history. They just wanted to play ball. Those great athletes, in their own ways, help humanize Black folks by their sports exploits. And there's something very American about that story. And it's our job to try and help more people, not only in this country, but around the world, understand everything that the Negro Leagues represented, which I think may be more important today than ever before. As human beings, we are obligated to continue to try to be better. We want to be better people. And I think that's what this museum is all about, showing that evolution where we've made strides, but then also helping people understand that we still have a lot of work left to do. Sometimes when you take that stance, you have to understand that you're going to walk in your conviction alone. It takes some moxie to take those stances. And it fills me with tremendous pride to see these young athletes using their platform, using their voices, using that stage that they have to help try to bring resolution to some of the things that we're seeing happen, the ills of our society that are still kind of perpetuating themselves to this day. And I'm proud of them because to me, they are absolutely embodying the spirit of the Negro Leagues.